In this video, we'll talk about the principles of vertical water flow in soil mass. And we're going to look at this example when we have two different soil layers, soil 1 and soil 2. We have a sand which is under artesian pressure, and we know that water will go rise up to level H. And we also know that the coefficient for permeability of soil 2 is twice of the coefficient of permeability of soil 1. So we can say that K2 is equal to 2 times K1. And the purpose of this exercise is to estimate the value in the piezometer, this H, at which the effective vertical stress in soil 1, in this layer, will drop to zero, and we're going to have quick conditions or liquefaction in soil 1. This is a very good example because we're going to look at the principles of vertical water flow, and we'll see how we can apply it into practice. What we need to do is we need to remember these two important things about vertical water flow in layered soil mass. So this one is the velocity of flow is the same through each layer. And this is what we're going to use right now. So what we can say that velocity of water flow in layer 1 is equal to velocity of water flow in layer 2. So which means that K1 times the hydraulic gradient of the first layer will be the same as coefficient of permeability of second layer times the hydraulic gradient of the second layer. So we just get it from here, from this statement that we have. So, and we also know that K2 is twice K1. So from here we can get that hydraulic conductivity of the second layer will be equal to 0.5 times hydraulic conductivity of the first layer. And this is what we're going to use later to solve the problem. So now we're going to look at the second statement, which says that the total head is the sum of the heads in each layer. So let's first find the total head for these two layers. And as already mentioned in my previous videos, we need to look for two water levels, and the difference in these two water levels will give us the total head. So we already know that the first layer will be the surface of the lake, and the second layer we have in the piezometer, it's here. So this difference is going to be total head. I'm going to call it delta H. And if we read this carefully, this first statement, it says that the total head, delta H, will be equal to the sum of the total heads for each layer. So we're going to have one for layer 1, and let's call it delta H1. And we're going to have another difference in total heads for the second layer. So in this case, we're going to say delta H2. So delta H, the total difference in total heads, will be equal delta H1 plus delta H2. So this is very important. And again, this is something that we are going to use later to solve the problem. Okay, now let's go to the definition of hydraulic gradient. And the definition of hydraulic gradient is delta H divided by L. So now let's rewrite it for delta H is going to be delta H hydraulic gradient times L. So now let's apply it for each of the layers that we have, for the first layer and for the second layer. So for the first layer, we're going to have that delta H of the first layer, it will be hydraulic gradient of the first layer times the distance for the first layer. And the distance in the first layer, it will be the thickness of the layer. because as we already know that water seepage starts from the bottom of the soil layer 2, goes all the way up and goes all the way to the top of the soil layer 1. So we have for the first layer, this is going to be L, so it goes from here till here. And for the second layer, L is going to be the thickness of the second layer, so soil number 2. And this is what I'm going to write it here. Delta H2 is equal hydraulic gradient of the second layer times L2. And what I can also do, I can rewrite it. This will be equal to 2 meters. So it will be 2 times hydraulic gradient of the first layer, and this is equal to 3 meters. So that's the thickness of the second layer. So I'm going to rewrite it as 3 times a hydraulic gradient for the second layer. And what we can do now, we can rewrite this equation as delta H, which we need to find. It will be equal delta H1, it's 2 times I1 plus 3 times I2. Okay, so this is good, this is what we already know, and also we know that this one, that I2 is equal 0.5 times I1, and again we're going to use it here. And another thing that we can do, we are going to, because we need to find H, we don't need to find delta H, we're going to rewrite H as delta H is equal H minus 6. Okay, I'm going to explain how I get this one. So if we know that this distance from the bottom of the soil 2 all the way to the level in the piezometer is H, this one, and if we need to find delta H, which is the difference between these two levels, so this is delta H. So, and we know that this altogether will be 6 meters. We have 1 meter of lake, 2 meters of soil 1, and 3 meters of soil 2, altogether will be 6. So we can rewrite that delta H is equal H minus 6. And we can also write it here, H minus 6 is equal 2 times hydraulic gradient of the first layer plus 3 times hydraulic gradient of the second layer. And if we use, if we replace I2 with I1, so we're going to get that 3.5 times I1 equal to H minus 6. Okay, so we still need to find this H. That's what we're after. And we have one unknown, which is hydraulic gradient of the first layer. We use hydraulic gradient of the first layer because for this problem, we need to find when the effective stress in the first layer, not the second layer in soil 1, will drop to 0. So we already know that when the effective vertical stress drops to 0, we're going to have quick conditions. So in this case, we know that effective stress is equal to 0. And we also know that for the quick conditions, another requirement for the quick conditions is when hydraulic gradient of that soil layer is equal to its critical value. So what we're going to do now, we're going to find the critical hydraulic gradient for the first layer, and we're going to substitute I1 with the value of critical hydraulic gradient, and that will give us the critical value of H at which the effective conditions, sorry, the quick conditions will happen. And to find the critical hydraulic gradient, we just need to know its definition. So we can do it either through specific gravity and void ratio, and this is what we can do for soil layer 2. But in our example, we only need to find it for the first layer, and we are given the unit weight, and we know that the soil is saturated because it's below the groundwater level. So in this case, we're going to use the definition of critical hydraulic gradient when we know the unit weights of soil. So in this case, unit weight of soil that is saturated minus unit weight of water and divided by unit weight of water. So in this case, we're going to have, we already know this unit weights of soil 17.64 minus 9.81 divided by 9.81. Well, approximately give us 0.8, which means that when the hydraulic gradient in the first layer reaches this value of 0.8, the effective stress in the first layer would drop to zero, and we're going to have quick conditions. So this is what we're going to use right now. We're going to say that this I1 is equal to 0.8. And when we calculate this one, we are going to find that for the critical conditions, H will be about 8.8 meters. Okay, so the meaning of this calculation is that when H, this value of H, increases and it goes close to the value of 8.8 meters, there will be soil liquefaction, or what we also call quick conditions, in the first layer.